Hello, I am Mercedes M. Yardley, and I'm going to be reading you my story called The Making of Asylum Ophelia, and it came out in the Miscreations book titled Miscreations, Gods, Monstrosities, and Other Horrors, which was edited by Doug Morano and Michael Bailey. I hope you enjoy. I'm just going to read you a little snippet of it in a few minutes. The Making of Asylum Ophelia by Mercedes M. Yardley. Being mad wasn't enough. She also had to be beautiful. Thankfully, Brigitte, whose name means strong, firm, healthy woman, chose the perfect name for her baby girl. She named her Ophelia. What is in a name? So very much, Brigitte thought. The name Ophelia brings so many things to mind. Wonderful things, emotive things. She knew her lovely daughter would wander around with a garland of flowers in her hair. How did she know this? Because she, Brigitte, with her sturdy hands, would make that garland herself. She would weave it through Ophelia's long, loose curls. Ophelia's tresses would tumble, of course. She would grow her hair long and sit at her mother's knee while Brigitte cooed and sang and brushed Ophelia's wild locks. She would sing songs of madness. She would sing songs of want. She would sing them in her husky voice until her winsome daughter sang them back to her, her voice clear like a bird's. Ophelia wanted to wear Wonder Woman shirts and dinosaur pajamas like the other kids that she saw through her window. But Brigitte, like her name and her solid orthopedic shoes, stood firm. "No, Ophelia," she said. She put her hands on her hips for emphasis, as her own mother had taught her. Pretty little girls should only wear white nightgowns. They look lovely when you ghost down the halls. When you become a woman, they'll flutter behind you as you walk on the moors in the night. Can you see in your mind's eye how you will glow under the moon? An unearthly thing of beauty? The evening's chill will prick your arms and legs, but you won't even feel it. You'll dance in bare feet, humming and swaying gracefully to music that only you will be able to hear. "What if I can't hear it?" little Ophelia asked. She wanted to play with trucks. She wanted to watch movies on her mother's tablet. But firm Brigitte took these things away and made sure she played with charmingly clumsy hand-stitched dolls and wooden figurines instead. "You'll hear it," Brigitte said loosely. "We'll begin music lessons soon, so you can always hear the music in your soul." Ophelia didn't go to school like other little girls and boys. Her mother taught her at home. She had teachers come in to teach her ballet and embroidery and Shakespeare. Brigitte worked at the large store across the moors, the local Walmart, and she locked Ophelia inside the house while she was gone. Ophelia learned how to curl up prettily in a soft chair in the reading room and pore over books. Both legs up, clean feet tucked away. She wasn't allowed to sprawl or spread her knees in a horrid, unladylike way, lest she spend the rest of the day in the closet. One day, as a young teen, she appeared in her mother's doorway. Her pale face had two bright spots of color in her cheeks. "Mother, I am reading Hamlet." Brigitte's eyes were stars. "My favorite. What a powerful story, yes? Family and betrayal and murder and madness." Ophelia's pretty mouth twisted. "Let's talk about this madness. It's an epidemic." "It seems to be." "Everybody loses their lives." Brigitte nodded. "Hamlet is Shakespeare's greatest tragedy." Ophelia shifted uncomfortably in her flowing nightdress. It had long bell sleeves which fell demurely over the leather books she held. All of her books were bound in leather. She wore a nightgown day and night, her feet kept bare, or perhaps slippered in soft-soled velvet shoes if the night was especially cold. Except for lessons. Her mother allowed her to change into corseted dresses for lessons. Ophelia's teachers had commented on the strangeness of a 13-year-old girl showing up for singing, piano, and dance lessons in a nightgown. "Mother, I want to ask you about Ophelia in the story." Brigitte's eyes glittered and her unpainted lips showed strong teeth. "Isn't she lovely? So charming, so tragic. Do you see how everybody responds when she hands them flowers? Isn't she the most wonderful thing? Their hearts go to her. Their mouths tremble. They accept her gifts and wear them near their hearts. She brings them together. Ophelia's jaw set, and Brigitte had never seen such an ugly thing in a child. She's mad, Mother. She isn't charming. She's crazy. She needs a psychiatrist and somebody to watch over her. She needs medications to stabilize her moods. She needs to get help and live somewhere other than that wretched place where they just let her pinwheel off into the water to die. Sturdy, firm, Brigitte stood up. Her legs were strong, her dark eyes imposing. She filled them with steel. Ophelia shrank back, her white fingers fluttering to her face, as they should. None of this unseemly talk, Ophelia. You will not abuse your namesake. Heaven knows the dear girl has had enough of that. Ophelia blinked large, dewy eyes and peered at her mother's face. You do realize she's just a character in a story, Mother. She isn't real. She asked so beautifully, so charmingly. Brigitte smiled and brought her rough hands to rest on Ophelia's feminine shoulder. Such sweetness in you, my child, she murmured, and kissed Ophelia's forehead. You will be remembered. Was I going to be forgotten? Ophelia asked, but her mother was already hard at work, head bent low over a new pair of slippers for her charming daughter. More than anything in the world, Ophelia longed for a friend. She didn't want to spend her evenings staring at the giant moon, which looked low and fat and rather carnivorous. Her mother got her a kitten, a fluffy white thing with a feminine ribbon tied around its neck, but he escaped into the night. Ophelia wished she could follow. You should, Brigitte urged, her eyes glowing hotly. Flee across the moors, shout his name. You won't find him, of course, but won't you be such a sight? Your tears will shine in the moonlight. Sadness makes a woman extraordinarily beautiful. Grief is the finest of jewels. Did you flee across the moors into the darkness once, Mother? Ophelia asked, and Brigitte's face became an old house. It was a rugged thing, weathered, and shutters fell over her eyes to protect them. The midnight moors are not kind to a woman named Brigitte, she said simply, and left. Ophelia did not go out to search for her kitten that night, although the front door was left not only unlocked, but standing open. The moon ran a tongue over its teeth outside. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you.